Before the gym doors were unlocked and the lights turned on, before any practices were ever held, there were few outsiders who gave the Glen Lady Eagles varsity basketball team even the slightest chance of winning the Suburban League crown. But fortunately, most of the Lady Eagles didn't see it that way.
No, I'm not surprised at all because we're a real good caliber team. And we have the talent to be the best, and we did it. We did our job, and that's why we came out on top.
I wasn't really surprised at all because I knew deep inside me that everyone, you know, that we were better than everyone thought. So I wasn't surprised about it because I knew we could do it all along, and I had confidence.
In the beginning, I thought it was quite a surprise because we weren't expected to have the success that we did. We weren't supposed to win league. We were supposed to be third or second place, and as it turned out, we came in first place. And in the beginning of the season, during preseason, we did pretty well, but the powerhouses of Bellflower and Artesia, it seemed that we didn't have a great as a chance beating them as we did in preseason, but as it turned out, we did, and it was great.
Well, it was kind of surprising that we took league because it wasn't planned this way. It was planned that we would take it next year, but when everybody works together as a team without getting into arguments or discussing what they're going to do for homework or they're going to do what they go out, everybody works together, and that's what pumps us up, and that's when we work as a team. But it came to a surprise, but then again, it didn't.
It was a long season for everyone, and even longer for the players who took part in the summer league games at Cerritos College. There are many factors that motivate a high school girl basketball player to go out for the team. But what motivates her to give 100% every moment she's on the court?
Sometimes it's for the coach, but in other cases it's for myself because I want to prove to myself that I'm good, and then I want to show the coach that I'm good so I can play more, so I keep up my intensity. Because I don't play that like often, but my defense, like, I feel I do very good at. And so like I try to prove to him that I'm good, and so I try like just play all my might, just try my best.
Well, there's like a little voice inside of me that just tells me, well, keep pushing, you know. And like when the crowd cheers, you know, real loud, it makes me excited. And of course, the coach yelling at you would make anyone, you know, feel that they have to do better.
I set goals for myself and try to get them. Just do my best. Just do what I have to do out there.
Make all the other schools feel stupid, and you know, like before, you know how we always lose to everybody and everybody used to make fun of us. Now I just shove it in everybody's face.
Well, first I always think about I always look at Mr. Drake, I always look at my coaches, and I always want to show them that I can do it. You know, he might not think I can, you know, saying I'm not aggressive enough, but I really am, and it inspires me when, like, I don't know, I just always want to show him that I can do it and not be a wimp or anything like he says and stuff like that. I just want to contribute to the team.
It's more fun for me to get out and do it because when I'm sitting out there watching him play, it's like I want to go get a piece of the action. I want to play. I want to score some points. I want to be known throughout the whole world. So, you know, you're just sitting out there and watching. It's like, oh, you got to get out there. You want to run. You want to get the ball. You want to shoot.
I want to play in the world game. I want to make it better than it's ever been before. I want to play in the world game. I want to make sure everybody knows.
Besides the days and days of practice, there are scrimmages, preseason games, tournaments, league games, and this year the quarterfinals of the CIF playoffs. But there are some moments that are magic and will live for years to come.
Well, I think I can say that for the entire team, I think it was the first time we beat Artesia and Bellflower the first round, because as Coach Drake said it, last year and the years before that, we had gotten really blown away by both of these teams, and this year it was really great to have beaten both of them by quite a score, and so I was that was really exciting. Even though, you know, this is my first year, I thought it was really exciting for me and for the whole team.
The best game we played all year, I think, was against Bellflower, the first round, because, and the second too, because we played really hard. At first we didn't think we could do it, but then we came together as one and we did our best and we won a championship.
Our first game of the season when we played Artesia. Well, like, for years, we lost against them, and this year, like, we wanted to beat them. And so, like, we managed to shut Aisha off. And, like, when the game was over, we're all excited because, like, we won them by a lot of points, like 13. So everybody's all excited, jumping, clapping hands. So that made everybody happy. It made the coach happy, too, because we won.
When we beat Bellflower, we made Suburban League champs. That has to be the most exciting thing. Everybody was so happy that we won.
The most exciting moment of this basketball season was when we were at Bellflower and there was only 7 seconds left, and we straight through the ball to Caprice and we won by 2 points. And that was the best moment of the season because we took league.
I want to make sure everybody knows the score. About using less, doing so much more.
The first question that arises when one thinks about the success this team has had and the improvements that have been made in the past 3 years is, what about the coach? What is there about him that has turned the Lady Eagles program around?
Coach Drake is like a Hitler and a teddy bear, because when it comes to being serious, he's very serious and will do just about whatever he needs to do to win. He's going to give it all he's got. But at the same time, he cares about all the girls and he tells everybody. He's a really loving man, and at the same time, a very angry man.
The high school years are a time of growth and development for all students. But being an athlete is special, and there are special things that can be learned only by the participation in organized athletics.
I've learned the disciplinary actions of basketball. I've learned how to play. It's taught me coordination and how to interact with others that are my age and younger, and it just teaches you companionship, and it actually shows you who your true friends are, because you realize out on the court that everyone changes, but everyone's still as one together by being on a team.
Basketball is real contact, so it's, you either make more enemies, but somehow you, like with the team, you make more friends, because a team is like bonded. You're together, you have to learn each other's ways, you have to adjust to each other's ways. And it makes you see how you have to adjust to other people's ways outside of basketball. It helps you see, like, if they have faults, you have to see around them, because they're part of you. You think of them as part of your team. And a team is, like, important because it helps you see a lot.
Finally, we come to one player who has been singled out for her accomplishments. Angelina has broken almost every record in the book and has been chosen to all-star teams and voted the league's best player. She'll return for one more year, What will be her goals as a senior next season?
Individually, well, to be a more all-around player. To be able to take more pressure and not get shut out. To be the best I can be. And team-wise, to take it all. Take it CIF next year, everything. I want it all.
The Glen Lady Eagles put together a remarkable season, made even more so because so few expected them to do so well. After bringing the league championship to Glen High School for the first time ever and representing themselves admirably in the CIF playoffs, one can only conclude that next year promises to be a year that won't be forgotten.